Welcome to fourth semester mathematics paper 4. The name of this paper is Modern Algebra, which has two parts. One is group theory, the other one is rings and fields. Group theory. What is a group theory? Group theory is the study of algebraic structures called groups. I will explain what is algebraic structure at the end of the class. Group theory will rely heavily on the set theory and modular arithmetic as well. Later on, it will require an understanding of mathematical induction, functions, bijections and partitions. Lessons may utilize matrices and complex numbers as well. Modern algebra is sometimes called abstract algebra. Abstract is derived from a Latin word which means pulled away or detached. Abstract algebra is a set of advanced topics of algebra that deals with abstract algebraic structures rather than the usual number systems. The most important of these structures are groups, rings and fields. That's the one we have in this semester: linear algebra, elementary number theory and discrete mathematics are sometimes considered branches of abstract algebra. Roughly speaking, abstract algebra is the study of what happens when certain properties of number systems are abstracted out. Now we are going to learn the very important and the basics of group theory or any abstract algebra topic, namely binary composition, or we call it as binary operation. As all of you know that when you say binary, it means two. In your computers, we use binary numbers,
zero and one.
But here the binary is not zero and ones. It can be any number, it can represent any two elements. What is the definition of binary composition? If A and B are any two natural numbers, then their sum, namely A plus B, is always a natural number and it has a definite unique value. That is, sum of any two natural number is again a natural number. Thus, the operation plus, namely addition, is an operation that joins two elements of the set of natural numbers to give as a unique element of the same set of natural number capital N. This joining process reminds us of the definition of a map. Another name for map is nothing but function. If we define a map or a function f from n cross n to n such that f of the ordered pair a comma b is equals to a plus b, that's a binary relation. Suppose take n is equal to a comma b. What is n cross n? N cross n is known as Cartesian product of n. N is a comma b, the answer set is also n, a comma b, then n cross n will be set of all ordered pairs, namely a comma a, the ordered pair a comma b, the third ordered pair b comma a, the fourth one is b comma b. So this is known as n cross n, because in binary composition or binary operation, we always consider the cross product. It can be n cross n or a cross a or g cross g or any set. So n cross n is a set of all ordered pairs of the elements of n, which is known as Cartesian product. So we know what is n cross n now. So f is from n cross n to n. If you take any element from n cross n, look at this again. If you take any element from n cross n, which is of the form of ordered pair, it can be a comma a or a comma b or b comma a or b comma b. It can be anything, but it's an ordered pair. Therefore, the function f is from n cross n to n is defined as f of whatever you write here, that is from the domain set. The domain set is nothing but n cross n, and we know that any element in n cross n will be an ordered pair. We are taking two elements here, a comma b, a comma b. Therefore, we take f of the ordered pair a comma b is equals to, what's the operation we use here? The operation is plus. Therefore, it is a plus b. Thus, we consider the function or a mapping f from n cross n to n such that f of the ordered pair a comma b equals to a plus b. The ordered pair a comma b equals to a plus b. This addition on natural numbers capital N is a map or a function from n cross n to n. We call such a mapping or such a function binary composition or binary operation. So when we say a binary operation or binary composition, it is a function from the cross product of a given set to the given set. It is here n cross n to n. In general, a function f is from g cross g to g is called a binary composition or binary operation in G or on G. We say binary composition in G or we say on the set G. A set G may have more than one binary operation or binary composition on the same set G. For example, just now we discussed F is from N cross N to N, where N is N set of natural numbers. In that case, addition is a binary composition on N. Also, if you take product of any two natural numbers, the result is also a natural number, and hence it becomes a binary operation. That is, the multiplication of any two natural number is again a natural number, and hence this operation, namely multiplication, is another binary operation on the set N. Thus, the set capital N has two binary operations. No, it has infinitely many, but for simplicity's sake, for the understanding's sake, we know about the addition of two numbers and the multiplication of two numbers. Therefore, here we consider the addition and the multiplication are the two binary operations on N. In fact, N will have infinitely many composition or binary operation. Here, what I want to say is, a set may have more than one binary operation. A binary composition star is called commutative. It is not new to you, because we are learning schooling as well as in the computer science, or we use the commutative property. A binary composition star is called commutative if A star B equals to B star A for all A comma B. A binary composition star is called associative if A circle B circle C equals to A circle B circle C. There are brackets here. Here the associative is change of bracket. Normally we write, we read A star bracket B star C equals to bracket A star B star C. But don't use bracket here. You simply say A star B star C. Give a gap. That gap stands for the bracket. Therefore, the closure, the associative property is A star B star C equals to A star B star C for all A, B, C. If star is a binary composition on a set G and A comma B belong to G, B, any two elements, then A star B must belong to G by definition of binary composition. That's the one we learned here. That is, sum of any two natural number is again a natural number. The same thing here. If we say something is a binary composition on a set G, if you take any two elements on the set and operate upon the binary operation, the resultant element must be in the same set G. That is the one written here. If star is a binary composition on a set G and A comma B belong to G, be any two elements, then A star B must belong to G by the definition of binary operation or binary composition. This fact is also sometimes expressed by saying that G is closed under star. This is a closed, this is called the closure property. See, whenever star is a binary operation which is defined on a set G, that the set G is said to be closed under the binary operation star. Maybe in the next slide we'll have a clear cut idea about this. The name is quite appropriate in as much as when two elements are joined through the composition, the resulting element remains inside the set itself. That's one here. If you take A and B are two elements of G, then A circle B will be a single element that is also belongs to G. In other words, the system remains closed under the operation, because which is inside the same set, which is closed, it cannot go outside the set. The elements are operated upon an operation, the resultant element will not be in any other set. It must be in the same set. This is closed. That's why it's called closed. It's not open. If it is open, it may belong to any other set. But here, the operation star operated upon any two elements of G, the resultant element is in G only. Therefore, we say it is closed. The concept of binary composition is most fundamental in the study of modern algebra, because in every definition, every way we mention about binary operation. Sum of two natural numbers is a natural number. For example, 3 comma 2 belong to n, then 3 plus 2 equal to 5 belongs to n. Sum of two integers is also an integer. For example, 3 comma 4 belong to the set of integers. Then 3 plus 4 equal to 7, single element. See that when you operate upon the operation, it becomes a single element. Now 3 plus 4 is no more two elements, whereas here 3 comma 4 are two elements. But 3 plus 4 is a single element belong to Z. Similarly here 3 comma 2 are two elements of N. But what happened here? The 3 plus 2 is a single element, 5 belongs to N. Similarly, minus 4, comma 2 belongs to N, implies minus 4 plus 2 equals to minus 2 belongs to the set of integers. That is, sum of any two integers is also an integer. What about difference of two natural numbers? Do you think that difference of two natural numbers belong to the same set N? Let us see. Consider 3, 2. 3 and 2 are two natural numbers. What is their difference? 3 minus 2 is equal to 1, which is also a natural number. But if you take 2 minus 3, what happened? 2 minus 3 is equal to minus 1, does not belong to N, which is outside N. Minus 1 is outside N, whereas the plus is always inside N. Sum of any two natural number is a natural number, that is inside N. Therefore, plus is a binary operation on the set of natural number N, and N is closed under addition. Whereas, if you take the difference of two natural numbers, the difference may belong to N, may not belong to N. But here, the difference does not belong to N. Therefore, we say the minus or the difference is not a binary operation on set of natural numbers N, and hence N is not closed. N is not closed with respect to subtraction or difference. What about product of two natural numbers? Yes, we already discussed. Product of two natural numbers is again a natural number. For example, 3, 2 belong to N. Then 3 into 2 equal to 6 also belong to N. Sum of two rational numbers is a rational number. For example, minus 4, 1 by 2 be two rational numbers. What is their sum? Their sum is a single element, namely minus 7 by 2, which is also belong to Q. Therefore, sum of two rational number is a rational number. Therefore, we say that the sum, namely plus, is a binary operation on Q, or we say Q is closed under addition. Difference of two rational number is a rational number. Unlike natural number, if you take difference of two natural numbers, the difference may belong to N or may not belong to N. When you take the difference of larger number minus smaller number, it may belong. But if we take smaller number minus greater number, that number does not belong to set of natural numbers. Whereas in rational numbers, rational number consists of fractions, all positive numbers and negative numbers including zero. Therefore, difference of two rational number is a rational number. For example, minus 4, 1 by 2, its difference is minus 9 by 2. Or if we take 1 by 2 minus of minus 4, that is also belong to Q. Therefore, we say the symbol minus, the operation minus, the operation namely difference is a binary operation on rational number, and the set of rational number is closed under difference. What about product of two rational numbers? Product of two rational numbers is also a rational number, and hence the product is a binary operation. What about quotient of two rational numbers? Yes, quotient of two rational numbers is a rational number provided the denominator not equal to zero, because division by zero is not defined. Now we are going to define what is a binary operation. We call it, let me call this as a formal definition. A binary operation or a binary composition circle in a set G is a mapping from G cross G to G. A binary operation circle in a set G is a mapping from G cross G to G. That is, if circle is a function from G cross G to G, then this circle is called a binary operation and the set G is closed under the binary operation circle. Binary operation is nothing but a function. Binary operation is nothing but a function. What's the domain set? Domain set is cross product of the given set. What's the codomain set? The given set itself. The circle may be, because the function here or the operation here may be addition or subtraction or multiplication or division or power of any number or any other operation or combination of these basic operations. The function is here, the function is an operation. Normally we write F, whereas in group theory we are not going to write F, we are going to use either circle or star or any other symbol or any other operation. But that operation may be combination of the basic operations, namely addition, subtraction, division, multiplication, power and etc. Note, it is customary to denote the binary operation in G by circle or by star or by dot or by plus etc. Generally we use dot or circle or star. For A comma B belong to G implies A circle B belongs to G. This implies star is a binary operation in G. Yes, because circle is a function. Circle is a function from where? G cross G to G. A comma B belong to G means we take two elements from G or we take one element from G cross G, then the final result, namely A circle B, belongs to G. Therefore, the circle is a binary operation and set G is closed. And this is called closure law. That is, G is closed under the operation circle. Binary operation is nothing but a function from G cross G to G. In that case, G is said to be closed under the operation circle. Let's take G cross G. This set is G cross G. G. When you say G cross G, we have to take two elements from G and only one element from G. When you say you take an element of G cross G, any element in G cross G will be of the form ordered pair. Say 2 comma 3. That is, 2 is from the first G, 3 is from the second G. Now 2 and 3 are natural numbers, n. And 2 comma 3 belongs to n cross n. Because I want to take here G as n. Now take the operation is multiplication. When you take operation is a multiplication, 3 comma 2 belong to n, G equal to n here. Because 3 and 2 are natural numbers. This implies, what's the operation here? Multiplication is the operation. Therefore, 3 into 2 equal to 6, which is a single element. Where is 6? This 6 must be in the set. Similarly, take integer A comma B and take the operation as circle. Then the final answer will be A circle B, which will be in G. Remember that we take two elements. The final must be in the same set G. These are examples we already discussed. When you take two elements from set of integers, here I have taken G equal to set of integers. Their sum is minus 2 is an integer. 3 comma 4 belong to Z. Take the operation circle as multiplication. 3 into 4 equal to 12 belongs to set of integers. Take minus 4 comma 1 by 2 set of rational numbers. Take the operation as plus here. then what's if you take plus is the operation, then minus 7 by 2, which is a rational number. When you say a binary operation, it is a function from G cross G to G. Normally we use G here. Hereafter, we are going to use G. The set is G because for a group, start with G. Therefore, let me take G as the set. The throughout the chapter in group theory, we always take G only. The set is considered as G, not A or B or C. So binary composition is a function from G cross G to G. In that case, the operation is called a binary operation, and the set or G is said to be closed under the binary operation circle. The operation may be any of the symbols. It may be addition or subtraction or division or combination of any symbols that we'll discuss in the example. A binary operation is a function. What's the domain set? Domain set is G cross G. What's the codomain set? G. And this function is called a binary operation. And the set G is said to be closed under the binary operation. This is an interesting example. The ordinary addition of numbers is a binary operation on set of natural numbers, set of integers, set of rational numbers. But in the case of irrational numbers, which is not a binary operation. Why it is so? The reason is, I'll give an example. 2 plus root 3 and 2 minus root 3 are irrational numbers, which you learn in intermediate schooling also. But what is the sum? If you add these two numbers, 2 plus root 3 plus 2 minus root 3, plus root 3 minus root 3 get cancelled, 2 plus 2 equal to 4. 4 is a rational number, which is not irrational number. Remember that 4 is a rational number. That is, sum of two irrational number is not an irrational number. It is outside, which is not closed. Therefore, the operation addition is not a binary operation on set of irrational numbers. Whereas this addition is a binary operation on any other number system. Maybe natural numbers, integers, rational numbers, real numbers, complex numbers, any set of numbers except irrational numbers. Therefore, addition is not a binary operation on set of irrational numbers, and hence irrational number is not closed under addition. So sum of two irrational numbers need not be an irrational number. Set of irrational numbers is not closed with respect to the operation addition. In the set N of natural numbers, the operation circle is defined by A circle B equals to A plus B by A into B is not a binary operation in N. The operation circle, see, we'll be using the function FS circle and the set is G, but here we take an N. Operation circle may be addition or subtraction or multiplication or division or anything or any combination of all these basic operations. That's the one already we discussed. Circle may be addition, subtraction, division, multiplication, power, or combination of these basic operations. But what is circle here? A circle B equals to A plus B divided by A into B. That is, the circle is a combination of three operations here. In the numerator, addition. In the denominator, multiplication. Between them, division. Therefore, the circle may be addition or subtraction or multiplication or division or combination of these basic operations. Here the circle is a combination of three operations, namely addition, division and multiplication. When you define like this, this is not a binary operation in N. How do you prove this? We are going to give you a counter example. Example 2 comma 3 belong to N. 2 and 3 are natural numbers. How it is defined? We are taking A equal to 2, B equal to 3. Then what is 2 circle 3? 2 circle 3 equal to A plus B. That is 2 plus 3 divided by A into B, 2 into 3. That is 5 by 6. Does 5 by 6 a natural number? No. 5 by 6 is not a natural number, so does not belong to N. But what's the definition of binary operation? We take any two elements and operate upon the operation, the resultant element must be in the same set. But here we are taking two elements from N, but the resultant element does not belong to N. Therefore, the circle is not a binary operation in N, and N is not closed with respect to the operation circle. That is, circle is not a binary operation in N. That is, N is not closed under circle. The ordinary multiplication of numbers is a binary operation in the set of natural numbers, integers, rational numbers, real numbers and complex numbers.